Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video we will be learning yet another interesting thing in Python, and it's for beginners. Like, it's about functions, how to use functions in Python. Okay, so I'll take an example and I'll show you like how to define a function and how to get your output from it. Okay, so I'll take a simple example, like to calculate area of a rectangle. Okay, so let's get started. So before starting, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel for the latest updates and stay tuned till the end of the video. You'll be able to see the output, how a function works, and if you feel it's worth it, you can always go ahead and click on the like button. So let's get started. So first of all, we have to define a function. Okay. Define a function for what? Define a function for creating the area of rectangle. Okay, so this is what we are going to do right now. So let's first create a function. So how to create a function? So for that you have to use the def inbuilt function which is there in Python, which is called definition. Okay, so that's a short form for def. So you have to write def, and suppose I take the function name as area underscore rec, that means area of rectangle. So that's my function name. This is called as a function name. Okay, so I'll be giving some parameters to the rectangle area. So what would be the parameters? Obviously the length and the width, right? So I'll name them as L and W. Okay, so here it should end with a colon. So this is how you write a function in Python. Okay, so I'm trying to calculate the area of a rectangle with the help of function in Python. For that I have taken area underscore rec as my function name, and these are my parameter, that is length and width of a rectangle. Okay, next what you have to do is we have to find out the area, right? So I'll just write area and then I'll write length cross W, okay, because length into breadth is equal to area of the rectangle, right? And then next I'll just write return, and then I'll write area because I want to return it. Okay, fine. So that's our first part. Next part, what I have to do is, since we have defined the function which is calculating the area of the rectangle, so how it will actually work? For this we have to give some input to the length and width, right? So that means user has to give the input. So our next job would be to get the user input. Okay, so for getting the user input, let's take a variable, let's say user underscore len. Okay, and inside this I'll be taking input from the user. So I'll just use a float so that user can enter both integer and float variable, numeric. Okay, and I'll use the input function. So input function is used to take the input from the user. So suppose I'll just enter the length of rectangle. Okay, that's for the length. I'll take another variable, user underscore, let's say W, and inside that same thing. So I'll do something, I'll just copy this one and I'll paste it over here. So here I just have to change this part, that is width. Okay, so these are my two inputs which I'll be taking from the user directly. Okay, now I have taken the input from user, I have defined the function. Now what to do, how to print it, how to print the rectangle. So for that you have to call the function. So call function and store the result. That's a third step. Okay, so for this what you have to do is, how to call a function? Suppose I take a variable r and inside that I just call my function name. So here the function name is area underscore rec, right? So I'll just write area and then underscore rec. Okay, And inside that, I'll be just writing my user inputs variable. So user underscore len and then user underscore w. That's my two variables which I have taken for the user input, right? So that is how you call a function. Okay, so the function name should be there and those variables should be there in which you want to store the result. Okay, now this is done. Now I'll be using the print function. Okay, so print, what I'll do, I'll just use print and then I'll write area of the rectangle is colon, and then I'll just write the variable r in which my function is actually called. Okay, so what is actually happening in this particular line of code, this line of code, this whole function will work. That means it will take the user from user input from these two line and it will give it to here in this function and it will calculate the area and it will give you the result in this particular line. Okay, that's it. Now what we have to do is we have to run this particular code. So for running it, you know, you can do it by right click and then run the main. Main means that's my name of this particular project. Okay, that is why any project if you want to create, you have to give a extension. That is, I have given main.py. You can give anything, and there is an extension py every time you have to give when you are creating a new project in Python. Okay, so this is pycharm. You have to give every time a extension whenever you are saving your project or creating a project. Okay, so let's go ahead and run it. So I'll just quickly run it from here, that is run main. So once I run it, see what's the option which is coming up. Let me expand it. So here it says enter the length of the rectangle. So what I'll do, I'll just enter any random number, suppose 98. Okay, and then it asked me to enter the width of the rectangle as well. Suppose I enter 45. Okay, now if I press enter, just see the output. It says the area of the rectangle is 4410. That means 98 into 45, 4410 is the area of the rectangle. That's it. That is how it got calculated. So how it got calculated, just flashback. So first of all, you have to define a function for any particular task you want to do in Python. Okay, so this is function definition. Okay, this part, ye jo part hai, this part is called as function definition. Okay, now this particular part which is there, this part, once my function is defined, then you have to take input from the user, right? User comes up over here, right? Now what I have to do is, once I have the input, once I have the function created, I just have to call the function anywhere in my program to make it run, right? So how to call it? So I'll just take another variable and call it with the function name. So what's the function name over here? Function name is area underscore rec, right? That's my function name over here. So I just use that function name and saved it inside the R. Okay, so that's how it is getting stored. And once you're trying to call that particular variable in which your function is stored, so here in this particular line of code, if you see, area of the rectangle is, I have just called it the variable. Okay, so inside the curly brackets, you have to every time use, whenever you're trying to call a particular variable in which your value is stored or you want to print it, so you have to use the curly brackets and then just run it, you will get the output. Okay, so once again, I'll try to run it, press enter, and then suppose 67 or 56 would be the width, and then yes, that's the output. So the output of the rectangle is this. Okay, so that's how the function works in Python. It's quite simple, easy, and it's very helpful whenever you're trying to code in Python a large code. So for a large code, what you have to do, just define a function, your whatever job you want to do, put it inside a function, and in any point of your program you can call that particular function just like I did, right? So that's how function works in Python. So hope you guys enjoyed this video and it's informative to you guys. So if you feel it is, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the like button, and do comment if you need any other information about any coding, whether it's C, C++, Java, JavaScript, Python, R programming, artificial intelligence related, anything. I'm happy to help you out. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Let's meet up in our next video. Bye-bye.